crazy.
The man can be manipulated. You can manipulate his mind very easy. Just tell him something he don't want to hear about Hogan, and that's it. The man goes off. It's very simple. Yes, they are playing mind games big time.
Well, the one thing that you do have to admit, however, is that they're going to put aside their differences. They both agreed on that for the match at the Great American Bash, and then who knows what's going to happen after that between the two.
Yeah, but can Luger and Sting put aside any differences they may have right now that they didn't have at the beginning of the night before Luger took the step and became NWO Wolfpack? Luger and Sting later on against the Giant and the NWO Hollywood Sting. That is coming up later on in this telecast, and you got to wonder what's going through the mind of one Sting.
Well, which Sting?
The Sting.
The Sting, oh, excuse me. Just trying to clarify.
Keep up with
people.
Me here. How long have you been listening to this stuff?
Listen
into the
to you
corner.
Much.
Feet to the face. Juventud Guerrero, a young man who has certainly had his problems with one of the biggest men in our sport, obviously the biggest man in the flock by the name of Reese. But Reese is not here, so Juventud may have a better shot here against a cruiserweight by the name of Kidman, Mike.
Well, this is really how Juventud's problems with the flock all began. It was a matchup against Kidman where he was doing moves just like that. Incredible flying head scissors takeover by Juventud. And he was dominating a matchup with Kidman when the other flock members hit the ring. Ever since then, we've seen Juventud involved with just about everybody in the flock. And look at that.
Look at that.
Seen one. Incredible suicide dive over the top rope.
Well, if Michael Jordan would have had that much hang time, they may have won today. Did you see him go over that top rope? He was 3 feet over that top rope when he landed.
It's unbelievable. And you know, two amazing things about Guerrero. Number one, that he can execute those moves. And number two, that he continues to get up, because they are such high-risk maneuvers, not only for the opponent, but for Guerrero as well.
Would you expect anything less from someone whose motto is never surrender? He's not going to stay down. Not long.
Do what it takes to win. And Lodi holds the sign you have seen here tonight, the flock almost disintegrate, disassemble before our eyes with the problems with Saturn, with the firings by Raven, with the young man by the name of Canyon in his home video, who was once known as Mortis. Raven has more problems. He knows what to do with, but Kidman still takes the fight to Juventud here.
Well, it was that momentary distraction from Lodi at ringside that opened the door.
Two
count, only two by Kidman.
Can't deny the ability of one Kidman, regardless of Kidman being a member of the flock.
Or is he? Is he still a member of the flock officially?
Well, now, was he in the ring when the firings were handed out?
Yeah, he was out there when he DDT'd Lodi.
Yes, he was. And so was Horace. So maybe there are three members without a flock to go to.
Eventually, we'll need a program.
I think we need one now.
Boy, to keep track of this, I'm telling you, so much is happening here so quick.
Yeah, when you keep track of the NWO roster, two factions, NWO Hollywood, NWO Wolfpack, and now put Lex Luger on NWO Wolfpack. One, two, we got a two count. Wow.
Incredible leg extension that time from Kidman as he connects with the dropkick.
Well, there's no doubt about it. Kidman is one great athlete and a great wrestler. He just happens to itch a lot.
Yeah, he does, but he has great body control, and that's why he had that leg extension. Get up in the air and still the presence of mind to execute that spectacular dropkick. Tonight, Lex Luger of NWO Wolfpack and Sting of WCW. Remember, Luger was offered on Thursday a chance to join NWO Hollywood, and he spit in the face of the Giant. But he didn't do any spitting tonight with Kevin Nash and Macho Man Randy Savage, did he?
Well, last Thursday, we saw that Lex Luger speaks the same language as Sting. Let's find out tonight in the main event if they're going to be able to coexist as a tag team. Juventud on fire. Oh, but he's leveled with a lariat by Kidman.
Kidman should go for the cover right now. He'd have him. Juventud's not getting up. Not getting up at all.
That's a good point, Brain, but he certainly had to adjust a knee pad and now wants to throw the man on the outside, and this may be a critical mistake. He leveled him with that running lariat. The momentum of both men. felt on the throat and the neck of Juventud. And as Mickey J tries to hold Kidman back, he goes back outside again. And now head first, gonna send him back in now. Can only wonder what that was all about. He had the man down, he threw him outside, went back in and threw him back inside.
Well, he's a member of the flock, and just by looking at him, his demeanor, you can tell the guy could lose concentration.
With the guillotine leg drop from the outside in, only got a two count. And he may be mad, but he only has himself to blame here.
You can yell at the referee all you want. That's not gonna do you any good. Yelling at Hoobie isn't gonna do you any good. You're gonna have to beat him.
Throughout of all this, though, Juventud gets a chance to get a second win. But can he? Into the corner. Kidman, reckless abandon, missed. And down he goes. Guerrero has nothing left to cover the man with.
He just collapsed. He had that one quick rush of adrenaline that allowed him to use the clothesline, and then he went down.
And Mickey J administering the 10 count to both men. They are both back up into a power slam.
Now everything's gone from Kidman. I think he just gave it his last shot too.
They're both spent at this point.
Kidman just crawling over hands and knees, lays on top of Juventud. Doesn't get him, roll up, one, two. Didn't get him the other way. Notice how Kidman just threw himself on top of Juventud, trying to get a quick cover here. And now that is a chokehold using the shin across the throat, and Mickey J knew it.
Smart move by Kidman. He counted right along with Mickey J right up to the four mark when he knew that he had to break or else he would be disqualified.
I always say, they put those rules out there, take advantage of them. Tell you to break by five, break it four. Take advantage of the rules they set in front of you.
And of course, as we know, they have certainly laxed the rules over the past few months here in WCW, and that's good for the fans. Behind, slips behind, back elbow. Look at this, almost a version of a Dragon Sleeper type maneuver.
But is he going to try and suplex him out of it?
I believe he is.
Inverted suplex attempt, but Hoobie, well, made it to the ring apron. Great balance, great agility. Juventud to the top rope.
It's time for Air Hoobie.
He's up and he's down with a flying body attack. Top rope plancha, nailed him. Here's the cover by Guerrero. One, two, and we...
Did he go?
Two, he says two.
I thought that was three.
Well, his hand maybe went down, but the shoulder probably came up.
Well, sometimes you listen for the thump or the bang on the mat, and I believe it was the kick out that made that last noise.
Wow, that was close.
To the midsection.
He's got him.
One, two, didn't get
him. No, he kicked out.
I know what's going through Kidman's mind right now. What does it take to beat this man? I've given him everything I got, and he still kicks out.
And you see how evenly matched things are now that this big man, Reese, is nowhere to be found interfering this. Great matchup here on Nitro. Rib shot over the top, waist lock, back elbow tries to disconnect and it does. But it's Kidman.
Look at those series of forearm smashes.
Release German suplex over the top. He almost tumbled in midair that time. And now Kidman, he may be going for the 7-year itch.
If he hits the mark, he's got himself a win. He's not going to, though.
Juventud moved out of the way. He dropped it on the way down.
Talk about being prepared and ready. Juventud knew that he was headed to the top for that 7-year itch and caught him with the drop kick coming off.
Got him right in the solar plexus. Took all the air out of Kidman.
And now Juventud. Hoobie drop.
Oh, yeah.
That's the setup for the 450. But he needs to get it on quickly. Fans are standing.
Oh, boy. Kidman's like the other side of the pillow.